The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, I tell you, unless your righteousness surpasses that of the scribes and Pharisees, you will not enter into the kingdom of heaven. You have heard that it was said to your ancestors, you shall not kill, and whoever kills will be liable to judgment. But I say to you, whoever is angry with his brother will be liable to judgment, and whoever says to his brother, Raka, will be answerable to the Sanhedrin, and whoever says, you fool, will be liable to fiery Gehenna. Therefore, if you bring your gift to the altar, and there recall that your brother has anything against you, leave your gift there at the altar. Go first and be reconciled with your brother, and then come and offer your gift. Settle with your opponent quickly while on the way to court. Otherwise, your opponent will hand you over to the judge, and the judge will hand you over to the guard, and you will be thrown into prison. Amen, I say to you, you will not be released until you have paid the last penny. Brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good afternoon, my dear brothers and sisters. Jesus, in our gospel passage today, used the example of offering your gift to the altar. Perhaps Jesus was observing the sin or guilt offering that was offered on the altar of sacrifice. If we will go back to the practice in the temple, when people commit sin, they offer a sin offering in atonement and forgiveness of their sins. Kapag sila ay nagkasala, nag-aalay sila sa altar. Iba't ibang mga alay. Nag-aalay sila ng hayop, nag-aalay minsan ng mga pagkain bilang kapatawaran sa kanilang mga kasalanan. A beautiful practice of expressing their penance, their sorrow of their sins. But later on, we will see that this practice was abused. If they commit sin, then they thought, I could just offer an offering and my sins will be erased. The practice was abused. They only focused on the offering and the thought and intention of reconciliation was no more. That is why in our gospel reading today, Jesus reminded his disciples that no amount of prayer and offering can erase your sins without reconciliation. You may offer the biggest gifts on the altar, but if in your mind and in your heart there is no intention to be reconciled with God and with your brothers and sisters, then no offering will be enough for that sin. Kaya mga minamahal na kapatid, sa araw po na ito, na araw ng Biyernes, isang araw kung saan nag-aalay tayo ng ating mga sakripisyo, tandaan natin, no prayer offering is enough without reconciliation. Tandaan po natin ngayong Biyernes na ito, let us not make our offerings and sacrifices as excuses to commit sin. The offering, the sin offering before, became an excuse. Let us not make that mistake again. Meron nga akong naririnig na nagsasabi, Father, kakain po ako ng bacon ngayong umaga. Magro-rosaryo na lang ako mamayang gabi, kapalit ng bacon. O kaya, Father, karne kasi ang ulam namin. Magsa-Stations of the Cross na lang ako, kapalit nung karne. Nako, that is what Jesus is telling us in our gospel. You are making prayer and offering as an excuse for sin. Kahit siguro makalimang Stations of the Cross ka ngayong maghapon na ito, if there is no reconciliation in your heart and in your mind, it will not be enough. That is why in our first reading today from the book of the prophet Ezekiel, the reminder of the prophet to the people of Israel is to turn away from sin. The prophet Ezekiel did not say, you pay for your sin. He did not even say, you offer something for your sin. The prophet tells us, turn away from sin. Hindi sinabi ng propeta, o mag-alay ka ng ganito para patawarin ang kasalanan mo. Hindi rin sinabi ng propeta, magbayad ka sa templo para patawarin ang kasalanan mo. No offering, no prayer is enough if there is no reconciliation. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, as we celebrate this Mass today, let us be reminded not to make our fasting and sacrifices today as excuses to commit sin. They do not erase our sins without reconciliation. Let us remember that when during Ash Wednesday, when the ashes are imposed on our forehead, there is one phrase or sentence that the priest tells us, turn away from sin and believe in the gospel. In this celebration of the Eucharist, as we offer our sacrifices to God, let us be reminded of the most important part of this day, turning away from sin and being reconciled with God and with one another. Amen.